profile photos. G'day folks, I'm Canva from the Jackson team here at Vibe. If you're looking to give your profile picture a glow up that it absolutely deserves, then you've come to the right place. In today's tutorial, I'll show you how to insert your photo into a range of customizable templates on Canva, as well as add any quirky features and or filters that'll set you apart from the rest. But before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel. Of course, do it, so you don't miss out on seeing any other great videos like this one. I assume it's gonna be pretty good, but we'll find out. So anyway, folks, let's jump straight into it. Let's pull up Canva and check out some templates. So to get the best results, I recommend searching Facebook profile picture. Of course, you don't have to create something specifically for Facebook, but this way you'll get square templates, which are suitable for most platforms. Look how many amazing designs there are. Wow, well done, Canva. Most of them are free for anyone to use, but see this crown symbol? These are only for Pro and Canva for Teams users. Just keep this in the back of your head when you are a scrolling. So, I like the simplicity of this one. It's sweet, but semi-professional, just like me. Thank you. Anyways, so to add your own photo, head to Uploads. Once it's finished loading, click and drag it into the frame. When you do it correctly, the frame will be highlighted and you'll see your photo fall into place. Look at that! If you need to crop the photo, make sure it's selected and go to Crop. Then click and drag the edges like this. You can also use this tool to reposition it if you need to. Unfortunately, there's no feature to make me more photogenic. Sorry at everyone. So this looks like it's ready to download. Let me show you how, folks. I'll click share, then go here and make sure I've selected JPEG before hitting download. Now I have a copy saved to my computer. I can upload it to Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, or even work platforms like Slack. Wow. Alrighty, that covers the absolute basics. Next, I'll show you how to customize the colors of a template to suit your style. How about this attention-grabbing shot? The pose is outrageous, but I love it. In fact, I've copied it for my own display pic. Thank you. Check it out. Why not? Have a look. If you're unsure what to wear or how to pose, I recommend using these templates as inspiration. They can help you decide on everything from the angle of the photo to the expression of your face. All the little things help convey who you are to your audience, so they should be considered. My three Facebook friends will thank me one day, that's for sure. You're welcome, Tony and Grace and Stefan. All right, I'll quickly add the photo, then it's time to change the colors. I've been told I look quite good in aqua, so perhaps I'll change it for the background. This hot pink is actually a pretty good match, so I'm not gonna ditch it. Instead, to help draw the eye from one side of the design to the other, I'll add it here and here. Absolutely lovely. These colors are definitely looking more me. Aqua, we love aqua. Actually, you know what would make this even better? More aqua! No, of course not, that's too much. I mean, changing my photo to black and white for some contrast. I'll go to Edit Image, scroll down to the filters, see all, and then of course, select Street. To adjust the intensity, I can click here and move the slider up or down. That's looking mighty fine, folks, if I do say so myself, and I do. That's looking mighty fine, said myself. Next up, I want to show you a template that incorporates a radial gradient. Check this out, I've already added a photo because this time I want to focus on how to create an interesting effect using duplicates. To create a copy of the framed photo, I can select it and click it here, or use copy and paste on my keyboard. It's just there waiting for us. Then I'll copy and resize it, center it, and then add another. As I keep going through this journey, the photos become smaller and create a cool kind of tunnel-y effect. Ooh, don't you reckon? Now to change the gradient background. First I'll click here and then I'll head up to the palette. Let's see what happens when I switch the yellow for a bright green. It's a subtle change, but I like it. Excuse me. Let's leave it there and move on to another design, folks. All right, time to dial things up a notch. Let's show you how to create a pop-out effect. Are you ready? I'm ready, yeah. So folks, first I'll add a pattern background. And then I'll add a circle frame to hold the same pattern. Only this time I'll rotate it around so the colors are on the flip side. Now for an additional frame to hold the photo. Before I drop this in, I'll remove the background by clicking over here. I should mention this tool can only be used by Pro and Canva for Teams users or anyone on a free trial, so you might want to look into that, folks. Okay, so that is ready to drop in. I'll just need to crop it so the hands expand beyond the frame. Now I'll add the photo again and perfectly align it with the one behind. Once again, I'll apply the background remover, but this time I'll remove everything except for the parts I want to sit outside of the frame. How trippy is that? Wow! Ugh. It looks as though I'm popping out of the page through a circular window. Absolutely wild. I'm all for visual illusions and quirky designs that make people look twice, even three times, but not four. That would be one too many times. Check out this one, or this one, or this other one that I've made using a stock image. I found this photo by searching art gallery. And replace one of the artworks with my own picture. Look at that. Take that, art cannon. To achieve a painted quality, I applied the photo effect called passion fruit, which I found listed under the heading Prisma. Check out the number of effects and filters available. Another one I really like is Trippy. Alrighty folks, I've got a few more quick things to show you before we wrap up. That was a wrap. Let's just say you want to add a few embellishments to a photo. We do love an embellishment. Simply type in whatever your heart desires and hit enter. Want a beard? No problem. Keen for an edgy, funky, cutting edge, contemporary edgy new hairdo? Can do, mate. Come on. Woo. The options are endless. In fact, you don't even need a photo of yourself in order to have a cute display pic. You can make something entirely from graphic elements, like this one, or this. Let me show you how easy it was to create this character. First, I searched custom avatar to find a body. And then I added some hair along with some other facial features that kind of look like mine. Sorry, mate. Lastly, I added a circle to the background and played around with the colors until I found a combo I liked. Come on. folks, and there you have it. Do you think it looks like me? I don't know, but perhaps I'm more handsome, or perhaps it's the other way around. But anyway, I think cartoons and illustrations are good alternatives when you don't have a decent photo of yourself, but nothing trumps the real deal. We want to see ya, especially when you can add a beautiful background and elements like we've done today. So, which was your favorite? I'm very curious to know. Let me know in the comments so we can all get a sense of what's most popular. And I'd love to hear how you plan to use it. Will you be posting it on social media or another platform? I think I'm gonna be using my one for my Google reviews. Watch out, everyone. And perhaps this one for the dating apps. Just kidding, but seriously, you could make people go crazy with this photo. People will be swiping right all over the shop. Watch out, everyone on dating apps. You might get RSI because you've been swiping so much, it's gonna be absolutely wild. Alrighty, folks, I know I said it before, but I may as well say it again. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, do yourself a favor and hit that button right now. We're uploading videos weekly and you won't want to miss out. And since you're still here, why not check out some of our other videos right now? Here are a few of my favorite suggestions. Folks, thank you so much for watching. Look me up on Facebook, my name is Jason. Can't wait to be friends with you all. Stefan will thank you, and Grace, and my other Facebook friend. See you later, folks. Ron Bergen, Jackson, Jason.